Today we are going to learn about word settings, top 10 word settings. Now settings means what? It changes the way the product behaves. So they will apply to all the documents. Let's start with something dark. Dark mode everyone likes because it reduces eye strain, correct? But at the same time, I don't want the document page to become black. So there is a setting right next to the dark mode saying never change document page color. Similar setting is available on browser as well. The second one is about formatting. Often we spend too much time formatting and repairing it. To understand exactly what is happening, enable hidden characters. That way you can see this is space, this is tab, and so on. It becomes easier to understand what is happening and handle it better. Here is one example. I have three columns and I want to convert it to a table. Between those three columns, there are spaces, tabs, very confusing. So select it, go to find replace. And there's a special thing there called white space. White space means any character which doesn't show itself, hidden characters. So whether it is tab or space, it's going to recognize all of them. And now replace it with one tab, and now you can import text as table. Can you guess what is the most common activity people do? No, not copy paste, that's second most common. The first most common I'll tell you at the end, but let's talk about copy paste. Invariably, the way you want, copy paste never works. And then you struggle, choose paste, special, but there is a set of icons here which is better. Choose each icon and choose the correct format you want. Now, the problem is, very often you're copy pasting similar things. So every time you copy paste and choose that icon, again, again, again. So that's where you can change the default copy paste. Yes, click on that set default and you'll be surprised to know there are four different ways of copy paste, and for each of them, there is a separate setting. Change those defaults and copy paste will never be the same for you again. Now let's talk about fonts. Most of the times we are using the default fonts, but in case of flyers, brochures, advertisements, marketing material, we do use exotic fonts. The problem is, if you send the document to someone else, unlikely that they are having those fonts. Now what will happen? The fonts will get replaced with some other font and all the layout and design goes for a toss. To prevent that from happening, before you send such documents, this is a document level setting. File, Options, Save, Embed Fonts. Now there are two ways of embedding fonts. Only the characters which are in use, it will be lesser amount of space increase, but the recommended option is embed all characters. Why? Because the other party can actually edit it if required. Most probably you have not noticed how powerful the grammar and language enhancement features of Word have become. Now it's called Editor. Editor opens a page on the right side and does all kinds of refinements for your document. It's not just spelling and grammar, many things. In fact, it's a most important idea for you to go to File Options, go to the settings. There are 100 plus settings. Look at all of them and enable the ones which are necessary for you. There are separate settings for bias, separate settings for resume, and separate settings for common mistakes which happen while writing. All of us use hyperlinks. Some hyperlinks point to another part of the document, some hyperlinks may be a web page. In either case, when you are using the hyperlink, click does not work. Why? Because the default is control click. Now you'll ask me, why should the default be control click? The reason is, when you are editing the document, if you click on it, you don't want it to accidentally navigate. That's why control click is the default. You don't like it? No problem. There is a setting to disable that. Disable this setting and now click will work as expected. Job done. I hope now you have understood sending attachments is a bad idea and sending links is the right way. Hopefully you're doing that. If you receive a link, there is a problem though. Why? Because when you receive a link in email, you click on it, what do you expect? It's a Word document. It should open in Word. But unfortunately, by default, it opens in browser version of Word. Now, if it's okay with you, fine. But I have seen most people getting irritated with it. Now they have to go and say open in desktop app every time, extra work. So if you don't want this behavior, there is a setting for that. Go to this setting and say if there is a supported app, open it in the relevant Office app. Now this setting will change Word, Excel, PowerPoint, all their behaviors, which is great. In fact, if you are from IT, all these settings can be changed globally by using group policy or Intune. When Word opens, it is in print layout view. That means it shows you how it will get printed, which is great, but there are other views which are equally good. If you're working on an outline, that means you are initially just putting your thoughts, main topics, subtopics. This is not the view. Go to outline view. Even if you have an existing document you want to rearrange it intelligently, outline view is the place to be. If you're working on the text and you're not worried about formatting, layout and printing, then draft view is faster. Now in print layout, if you zoom in, obviously text will get cut off. If you want to zoom in without truncating the text, use the web layout. Why? Because it just converts your Word document to a long web page and zoom in as much as you want, nothing will get cut off. If you are just reading the document and you want to concentrate, understand, imbibe, then the correct view is immersive reader. In fact, I have a separate video on that. Have a look at it. It'll change the way you read, not just Word, emails, PowerPoint, everything. Bottom line, use the right view. And in any view, you want to see the structure of the document, enable navigation pane. Of course, for navigation pane to work, you have to use heading styles. See this video for details. One of the places where AI has dramatically improved is dictation. We have been struggling with Windows voice to text for a decade, but now the dictation is outstanding. But the first thing you do when you are using dictation is go to the wheel, open the drop-down, and choose the correct language. Even if your language is English, various types of English languages are there. So in this case, I use English India. You use the correct variant of the language, then the accuracy improves even further. Another related thing, there are microphones. If you have only one mic, no choice, but often we have multiple mics. Choose the best mic. If you don't know which one is the best, do some trial and error and choose the correct mic to get better accuracy and better recognition. You remember I asked you to guess what is the first most common activity? Second is copy paste, first is undo. Yeah, you'll be surprised. Now undo, you'll say, okay, what is the harm in that? No, it's really bad, because when you make a mistake, doing undo is okay. But very often when we do undo, it is because we did something hoping that something will happen, that did not happen, and now we have to come back to the previous state and struggle again. That's the common use of undo, and that is basically telling you that you don't know how to do. That's why you have to do undo. So every time you undo, think, is it exposing my inefficiency? If it is, then find a better way so that you get what you expect. So even undo has a deep meaning. Did you think about it that way? The last one is the search box. There is a search box, universal search, whatever we call it, on the title bar. That's different than find. Control F is find within the document. That search box on the top is universal search, so it'll find commands, help, and things like that. It's a good feature, but that title bar has a long, big text box. I don't like it at all. So if you want to get rid of that text box but still have search functionality, use this setting. Instead, show an icon. Now, Alt Q is the shortcut ideally. You should remember, so whether it is text box or icon, you don't have to ever go there using mouse. Alt Q, the best way to search across products. These are the top 10 word settings you can change right now. If you like them, like my video as well and share it with as many people as you can, because let many people benefit. I create many such videos, so subscribe so that you come to know about them immediately. And most importantly, you tell me, did I miss something or something didn't work as expected? I'll be happy to help you. Before we go, Word has a very powerful search. You have no idea how powerful it is. I have a series of 4 videos on how to search in Word. It'll change your life if you work with Word extensively. Have a look at it. So that's it for now. Thank you.